pretty much anything, swap the roles.
Yeah, and Alliance are going to be thrown for a bit of a loop here, I'd imagine. Guys, try it in your pubs. We got some Omni Knight mid action. It'll be great, I'm sure. No problems at all. Well, we've got Loda down here in the bottom side. He's going to be playing the Chaos Knight. This is a terrifying lane to me. Handskin pudge people forward, and you know the hooks, the rots, also the stun from Loda. There's some kill potential here.
Yeah, Pudge, really popular hero these days. Got buffed through, like, what, 6 patches?
Yeah. For me, one of the big ones was when he ended up getting the rot slow at a constant duration, regardless of level up, so it's that was pretty great for him. Oh, they're moving in to try and contest the rune. Loda stepping up to it, and Matumba Man is going to be forced back. Doesn't want to end up committing that first point for Repel to head in, and probably would have been a bad idea anyway, so Alliance end up taking 2 bounty runes there. We get the third in short order.
Antimage is going to have a fun time at the top. He's just going to free farm, especially versus that Darkseer, who has no stout shield, went for Iron Talon build.
Yeah. Do you like this choice?
No.
Okay, cool. Alright.
Well, once they burn his mana, he's just trying to go here. He's going to get some levels. We'll try to go jungle later on if it doesn't work out well for him.
You also have GH that can wrap around and try and do some damage to Limp. It might be a bit tough. They need to whittle him down over time here. But man, trading hits and such, but I'm sure they'll have done the math and figure out what the right timing is. Maybe at Omni's level 3 when he has 2 points in purification?
Well, I think he's just going to go now, try to harass him a little bit.
Okay. Yeah, punch him in the dome. Why not? It happened. So
bottom lane, Batrider just forced to go to jungle. Can't stand on the lane against Pudge, Dazzle, CK.
Oh, he's going to lose all these stacks too. So no sticking it. Oh man, that's a really tough one for mind control.
Yeah, this Batrider's going to have a hard time this game.
Absolutely.
He won't be able.
Miracle.
He won't be able to come to lane anytime soon.
This lane is so frustrating to play as for Jonas, and it looks like they are still going to be able to get a ton of denies. I remember correctly, wasn't Miracles like one of the first heroes they really started playing like crazy? Was Anti-Mage? It was that and his Shadow Fiend, I think.
Yeah,
right?
I think it was. Well, GH just stealing the rune, trying to maybe predict the movement of Darkseer. If they go on him, he would probably Darkseer thinks I'm gonna go to the shrine. He maybe tried to go on him, but he wasn't that low. He's gonna try to steal a creep, and he will do it again.
Nice. GHA now. You know, I'm going to mention this just real quickly. After the Liquid win the other day where they ran the Sniper and the OD, there was a tweet by Matumba Man. He was just like, of just a bunch of 9k people, is GH trying to get the courier? He's going to end up dying to the sprint. He's going to not
nice.
Get it. Oh. First blood drawn by Jonas somehow. But he was tweeting about how it was like, you know, they're just running around doing silly stuff as 9k people. And I was like, it feels like whenever Liquid are playing these games, they're having a lot of fun. They're experimenting. They feel like they're untouchable. And that's a cool place to be playing Dota 2 from.
Yeah, I agree on that one. If you're really confident and you have a good... Oh, nice hook.
Oh, Repel. Not so confident anymore. Repel, body blocks, maybe in some trouble.
Someone's
once this
tipping.
Wears off, they're going to be able to
it's
do it.
Slider tipping.
Making the play, can they do it? The turnaround Limp is gonna end up going down to some Matumba Man ends up falling. Somehow Limp is gonna walk away from
GH's
this one.
Gonna die
GH
as well.
Always wants to die, no! He's gonna end up falling too. First the Courier, now the Ember. It's all gone wrong for Liquid.
Wow, GH died twice in a row.
All right, Handskin has been playing a great Pudge, by the way, too. Those two hooks. Through creeps both times.
Don't think the second one connected. The first one did. The second one, I don't think it did. Not sure.
Okay.
Well,
wow.
Loda is having a good time bottom.
Yeah. I still am concerned though. Like, so what's the problem with CK when we're playing in these games? Like, what do you need to be concerned about or worried about? Is the hook in? Oh, nice little pick off there. All right, hand skin, nicely done.
Wow. For CK, he needs a lot of farm, and if you're playing from behind, that hero doesn't have farm potential. Like, he needs to hit one creep at a time. Doesn't have any spell that gives him a lot of GPM, so he needs to have other heroes doing good in other lanes, take some towers, and he needs to have a free farm, maybe even buy a Midas so he can compete with other heroes such as an anti-mage, for example.
So it's not a hero where you would necessarily want to go for like a fighting items and try and farm heroes. You really have
fighting
to.
Items if you want to end the game real quickly. But he needs something to transition into late game as well. He scales very well. That's why.
Right. We can see they're all setting up down here in the bottom lane. Top, there's some more shenanigans going on as Miracle is facing off against him. But they're all going to coalesce onto Loda. They glimpse him back in. Kuroki found him. Damage being dealt out. The 1 second stun, not enough. And if he's not careful, they're saving the stun from GH as well, which be enough to be able to get the kill. Crush. Oh, they pull nice it back hook. In and it's not going to be enough there. It does look like Hanskin's still going to get ran down, running through the Firefly. EGM healing him up from their side.
And doesn't have a grave. Okay, he just leveled up, being level 4.
There he goes. And they might be able to find a kill.
He'll try to suicide, yeah. But Dazzle...
Dazzle's looking okay for the moment. Loda jumps back in. He only gets another 1 second stun there. He only have one level. He has 3 points in it. And still getting the minimum stun duration. That's why they call him the Chaos Knight.
Luck Knight.
Oh, everybody gets out.
Well, it's either you get a lot of damage and less stun, or a lot of stun and less damage. That's how it works.
Right. So... currently, CS board looking pretty much all Alliance at this stage. I mean, at least the Batrider is really committed hammered. That's the big takeaway here. You compare him to, you know, both the Ember and the CK, and they've been having a great time so far as Darkseer is forced back and away.
That patch kill on Anti-Mage really changed a lot for them. If you look at the Anti-Mage farm, he's on pair with Chaos Knight, but look at the Darkseer, he's on top one as well, top one, top two, constantly changing.
Yeah. I'll pull back in. Kuroki gets the stun, is going to be able to get the kill. GH and Mind Control here trying to deal with them, but Limp is showing up as well. Chains connects onto one.
A little bit of misplay.
That's not what you want to see, but GH still going to be able to find that stun. Another really long duration one, and that is going to be another kill going back the way of Alliance. Contentious start to this one. About a 700 gold swing, and out of it going into that coffers of that CK is bottom lane. More action. Mind Control hooked back in, and they find that kill too. Man, Alliance have looked, they've shown up to play.
Yeah, 7-1. They look strong this game. What I feel is teams that can play Pudge, I think those teams can pretty much beat anyone. Like, just land a few good hooks and you're good to go.
Alright. Limp, up against this, he needs to be really careful. If they get a good purification off, it's just gone. One of the nice parts about Omni Knight, obviously, is that pure damage. Got a rune as well. So next couple of minutes here, what are we going to be seeing from each of the teams? Is there anything that kind of stands out to you?
Disruptor needs to get level 6 so he can be efficient against Dazzle and the Ember Spirit. I think Liquid's just gonna take it slow. They don't have that much of any initiation or gank potential at the moment. So they're just gonna play it slow. And Alliance gonna be the ones who will be playing aggressively. Oh, look at the bottom lane. Pudge with speed.
Yeah.
And I missed hook, but still gonna die.
Yeah, nice little combo there. They pulled together, and it was looking scary for a moment by Loda. He dropped down very low, but Hanskin's already been able to build up into this urn, so nice movement in, and I'll end up being okay off the end of it. This movement by Kuroki, I don't think that they can do much to Jonas. Like, Miracle is taking a ton of damage over time.
Oh, there's one TPing. Potential. Yeah, now.
All right.
Let's see.
This should be the kill. He does still have the Ion Shell on him, so pull him back in into the crush.
Anti-Mage got the ulti up, so he's going to blow him.
Oh, they dropped the wall, but it wasn't on top of Miracle's head. That might have been enough for the kill with one or two swipes, but he probably could have blinked away anyways.
Pudge looking to get that level 6, so they can kill that Omni-Knight easily. They're gonna use the Shrine. Oh, it feels so good to use Shrine on like 3 or 4 people.
Oh yeah. Value. Value, value, value. Mind Control still heavily hampered, the second lowest net worth in the game below the Slardar, and it's feeling like he is just not gonna get his Blink Dagger in time. This has been, all accounts, a pretty disastrous laning phase for Liquid. 4,000 net worth into the favor of Alliance. And it's fairly easy, too. I don't know if it's just the drafting or what exactly has changed.
It's a high... Their tri-lane, Alliance's tri-lane, has really high kill potential if you look at it from level 1 with just Rot or maybe even a Hook if he wants to skill it. Plus Dazzle, Poison Touch, plus CK. You can't stand on the lane against that. Oh, let's see what's gonna happen.
They drop the ward, limp there, chains are there, the hook is gonna follow, and there's the first dismember of the game used as they take him down. Matumbo Man shows back up, so they don't have dismember to try and take him down as Rengar, or rather the Remnant away.
Kuro being level 5, a bit under-leveled at 11 minutes, not getting level 6. He's gonna get it now. Or, no, he moved from the XP.
Actually, thinking about going back in, Hanskin doesn't have enough mana to make this work right now, so not exactly sure what their idea is outside of just using a hook after the stun. Maybe they can kill off Burrow at that point?
And they're smoked. They know they're denying a tower.
Oh god, no, they pull him back in. Kuro going to drop off of this one, and they still are TPing back into the tower.
They still
crush
have a shrine
on the limb,
ready. They used it.
There is going to be able to do this, doing a lot of damage, trying to find the kill. Disruptor, whatever, dismember,
but there are
is
only
going to
two
kill
of them.
Off that Slardar. They pull back in Mind Control. He's gone too. So they lose Handskin, but they take down 3.
Really nice play from Alliance there. Use smoke. They saw tower was deniable, and then they decided to go in. Darkseer has a mech ready, which is gonna help them a lot in those pushes. They can dictate the tempo of the game right now with Pudge being level 6, soon 7, and that mech...
Just noticed the EGM build as well. He's going for 4 points in Poison Touch. It's not often you see that. What do you think about that build?
Yeah, it's a viable build. A lot of people just try to go with what other people do, but I like... Because it's stacked in a new patch, the 2 poison touches, they stack.
Right.
So 7 seconds cooldown, and the duration is 10 seconds. So you still get that extra 3 seconds plus Medallion of Courage. He's really farmed. He's 5-0-4.
Yeah, he's had himself a hell of a game. And here's the big thing. Eventually, level 25 talent, minus 6 second cooldown. There's the dream.
Well, but... just throw those poison touches. What, it's one second cooldown poison touch, so you can have 10 stacks of poison touch, legit.
Oh god. Well, this right here, they dropped the static storm. That was not the one they were hoping for. Jonas is just like, well, I got a shrine right here. What are you doing?
Well,
get away from me.
Let's get back to one second poison touch again.
Okay, alright, you want to talk about that some more?
Well, if you get 100 cast range, maybe get Aether Lance.
Okay.
All right.
Just spamming it out like crazy. Why not? Oh. Well, that's some T-Tours right there. That is an Omni-Knight dead in the middle lane. So a little bit off mark there for me as I was trying to... settings. And it looks like Miracle is going to be able to get into that Fury pretty shortly. Poison touch, but just going to be annoying.
Well, you asked why Anti-Mage is not a popular pick. These days, you see this hero has a hard time. They're gonna lose tier 1 towers, maybe even tier 2 towers until Anti-Mage comes into the game. And even that, if he comes in, makes a mistake.
Oh, see. And mind control down bottom. They just surged forward, handskin, and they find another kill. Killing spree for him. This is just domination.
Pure domination, 15 to 2. This Omni Knight mid is not really paying off. 0-2-0.
Yeah.
Well, they only have 2 kills, so... Well...
I mean, it was decent in the laning stage, though, right?
Yeah, it is. It is.
But...
Well...
Tough one, indeed.
Liquid is far behind, but... Oh, nice hook.
Oh, my God. All right, G. Gonna get ran down here. They have the wall. Vacuum onto 3 of them. Static Storm, again, only catches one, and it's Jonas, and it really hasn't even caught him. Loda takes down Miracle as well down here in the bottom lane while all that action was happening. So not only do you not win the fight without their carry there, you also end up losing your own carry. Just a dumpster fire of a game right now for Liquid.
Yeah, plus you're gonna lose the tower and your wall... Is dropped. I mean, Static Storm is dropped. Oh, that hook, not a good timing for it. Hey, it's easy to set up hooks with Searing Chains, and then just hooking right after that. They should just stick to it.
I mean, you know, I almost feel like you can't completely blame Liquid for this as far as performance-wise. Like, the draft was a little bit off the mark. Maybe the CK pick, they weren't expecting as hard of a, you know, heavy hitter in the laning stage as they saw, but...
It's not about...
I think Liquid...
This is not about CK. CK is free right. Farming, has a Midas...
I'm trying to get him off the hook here.
Yeah,
man.
Okay,
like,
this is
I'm doing
small
my best.
CK. No, CK will come in later later in the game, but it's a Darkseer plus Pudge and some good Dazzle plays on top of Ember Spirit as well. If you check check the scores, you'll see 6-0-4 Dazzle, 1-0-7 Ember Spirit. It tells a lot. Score doesn't mean anything, but if you only have 2 kills, well, then it's a different story. 16-minute Battle Fury. Still decent timing.
Yeah. The problem is it would be a lot better if it wasn't for all the deaths that have been going on his team. And he's 1-3-0. But we'll be able to get that tier 1 tower. There's going to also be another one taken by Liquid. So maybe you end up looking at this situation. If they can somehow hold on for another, 15-20 minutes, the game does start to change as the hook pulls back in onto GH, Gonzo, and...
Really nice play
take the
from
tower.
Pudge. All game long, getting those hooks. What you said is true. If they can drag it for 10-15 minutes and the Anti-Mage gets some items, they can still win the game. Batrider is getting close to his Blink Dagger.
Never give up, never surrender. Way of life. Guardian Greaves, though, on Jonas, and taking a look at some of these other items, the Lotus CK. I don't know if I've seen a CK win a game of Dota 2 in a long time, but he's certainly well on his way to do it. Is there any other sort of big pickup for him that you really like? Is it? I mean, Echo Saber seems to be the call.
He is going for Echo Saber, but I don't know if it's a right pickup for him. He can always go for Manta. BKB here, it's optional. Maybe he can even consider going for a Diffusal Blade for that. Oh, never mind. My bad. You can't purge Repel anymore. Oh, just ult, so it's pretty useless. Well, classic tank up build with Heart later on.
You know, I gotta say that, at least for the moment, Miracle has been able to catch back up in terms of net worth. He's
on
even
top.
Standing right now. Yeah, like, this is what you are expecting to see.
Yeah,
but
that's why
not far as ahead as you would like.
That's why I said the CK needs Hand of Midas.
Another hook. And skin. has just been a terror in these games, and now the TP is starting to show up. They are going to be able to break the TP of Matumba Man. No rappel used, and is going to end up paying the price for it. They're going to be able to glimpse away one, but the chase continues. GH down. Kuro going to be able to walk away, at least for the moment. Wait, was he? Did he get the vacuum back? No, he didn't.
No.
They take down Omni nonetheless. And over here to the side, the chase could have continued there.
Watch TPing bottom. Let's see if they can kill Anti-Mage. Oh, he knows they have a vision on him.
Yeah.
Oh. Aether Lance on Pudge, getting, let's say, close to his Blink Dagger.
This is all going Alliance right now, and we're getting dangerously close to a meme as well. Score screen.
Still two kills only on Team Liquid. Yeah, you see, the talent trees on Chaos Knight are really good. It depends what you want to build. We saw Chaos Knight with Helm of the Dominator. Then he, instead of 7th int, he goes for 15 attack speed. If he skips that, he goes for 7 int so that he doesn't lack mana, which he gets from Helm of the Dominator. Same stats, 6 plus 6 plus 7. It's really cool.
I love these types of build. I noticed it a lot on Weaver as well, where it's, you know, you can either go for survivability through your talents, or you can go through survivability through items with something like a Lincoln's, and then just build straight damage items if you go through it through your talents. So I like the way that a lot of these talents have been implemented.
Yeah, it brings so much to the table. You don't need to get a certain item, but you can get a talent tree instead of that.
Yeah. Well, does not feel right now like Liquid want to fight.
Yeah, they just want to...
I'm going to... They're back in the hell away.
Yeah, they just want to dodge as much as they can.
Top lane, though, they've caught Miracle. Oh, that creep! The value creep! They throw down the Static Sword. Actually, they might be able to turn back around into this. Handskin taking some damage. They throw it out. They are going to be able to get that kill.
Oh,
there's
nice
going to be
play.
Ember jumping back in, Limp, making the plays happen. He has the Ion Shell on top of him, and LGH trying to crush away. They're going to be able to glimpse Limp back, but they do still find that kill. Matumba Man on the other side. Nice juke by GH, but they are still going to chase. He is very low, and no TP for him currently. We'll see if they can cut him off. Doesn't look like it's going to happen. As a master,
yeah,
it was quite a display.
Anti-Mage close to his Manta style. I think that can change the fight. It just needs repel.
Yeah, like hypothetically, they can kill these people. This is
hypothetically yes, but
yeah,
somehow they're not managing to do it.
It's very tough. Okay, very, very tough right now.
6-0-6 Dazzle with one level Grave and Solar Crest. It's not what you see every day.
Well, that's a hero and a half. And Alcuro has Static Storm back up. Start putting this together with the Manta style, a Miracle, and a big Mana Void. Potential there, be it hard. Just another Ion Shell there on
Dazzle
Handskin.
Trying to put a ward in their base. It's gonna mean a lot for them. Plus one sentry, so Pudge can hook people out.
AM doesn't have a TP that's off cooldown for a little while now, so the rest of them are gonna kind of come back in waves. This is making what is already going to be a very tough defense even more.
They don't have a vision on that Pudge. Funky. They don't see where he is at.
Yeah, there's the hook. Ooh, just off the mark. Tumba Man not able to find it. Now they do have a better idea. They place down one of these boards. Mind Control
gonna go.
Could go for the lift up. Thinking about making it happen. Miracle is here as well. They pull back in Handskin.
Oh,
no,
nice reaction.
Oh, and he's not there. He is still going to be able to go up. They drop the Static Storm onto three. Is it going to be enough there? The Vacuum Wall, though, also going to be able to turn it back around. They pop the Shrines, trying to stay alive, and doing a lot of damage. GH, another good crush. They also get off the Omni Ulti, and Loda pops his ultimate.
No one dying still. Still zero deaths.
I feel like this is going to end up favoring Alliance again at the end, because all of those big ultis were integral for them to be able to find the kill.
Yeah, everything was dropped, even Guardian Angel, Static Storm. Yeah, they're just gonna take the Raxus.
Hook. Oh, good dodge away. The Crush connects onto Loda, and they jump with Miracle onto the back line with the Repel there, trying to see if they can find a pickoff, but Handskin found the real one, and GH, not long for this world. Loda
is going to end up dropping.
That's going to end up being a pretty rough kill. So they trade off the carries one for one, but Aegis,
he has a buyback.
Pretty good.
He has a buyback ready. He's not going to do it. I think they're just going to leave this Rex to fall. It's not going to make any difference.
Chains going out. They do have a glimpse back, just trying to create any separation possible. Good blink wake by GH, but feels very tough for them to get anything done. They also dropped the urn charge on top of GH, so we can't blink and chase. So Alliance making it work for themselves, and now they drop the weave down. EGM throws the poison touch onto GH. He's going to be stunned in a second here as well. Loda is not going to take nearly enough damage. Now Handskin chases after mind control, and this should be a kill. The hook is available. Actually, no, he's out of mana for it, but still mind control dead.
Yeah, his last few hooks were not on point. He was hooking either creeps or his teammates, but still they're managing to win the fights. Even GH died to limp.
Yeah. This is pretty messy now for Team Liquid. 20,000 net worth and almost 15,000 experience into the lead for Alliance. Hopes and dreams left on Miracle. It is only one lane of Rax, and there is no Aegis now either. God, is he gonna know? Are they really gonna do this?
Oh, he used Rot, can't blink. Let's see. Yeah, they saw him.
Oh,
triple Remnant,
God.
Root.
Miracle.
Yeah, man,
able to blink out.
Out
and away. All right, that was very close to disaster, and they managed to escape. But it is still a heart now on Chaos Knight. And I find it hard to imagine how you stop them in this next round of items coming up on online for Alliance.
CK is so farmed. Even has more net worth than Anti-Mage, which is really rare to see, considering that he doesn't have any farm ability.
Not even at that level 20 yet with the plus 120 gold per minute. Take a look at maybe some of these talents. There's not a lot that's outside of the norm, it looks like. He's taking the
pretty much normal stuff.
Lincoln Sphere, was that what I heard?
Yeah, for Ember Spirit.
Can place that down onto Loda as he stands for high ground. Well, not able to find any chains. They have the weave down. AM still farming away, trying to get himself into some semblance of relevancy. Loda beats away at this tower. Static Storm, integral to their plans to defend the base. Honestly, Kroki should just glimpse the illusions, get some arm for himself. Well, I guess that they're going to need that for the
fight.
Yeah,
get that 10 gold, 15 gold. Well, at least it's something, huh?
Yeah. The plus side to this is that if Alliance do happen to fight when Ember Spirit comes back in for the Remnant, they could glimpse him back out to the other side of the map, and that might be a game-changing moment.
Might be. CK building that BKB tank is gonna tank up even more. They're just gonna go for the next set of racks. Try to land a hook, go slowly.
Yeah. Matumba has the blink too, so he's not going to try and put himself into harm's way at all. And just waiting for that opening. Hopefully it comes out. Also, no ward at this point. They pull back in their creep.
I'm surprised Anti-Mage is standing in the base instead of trying to push the mid lane. Well, it's hard against Ember Spirit with Boots of Travel. You can just clear it and come back. But still, he shouldn't be in a base.
So, Loda. I mean, it almost feels as if they're just going to wait for that next round of Rosher. Yeah, slowly
Phantasm,
beat away.
It's a level 3 right now. Plus, he might get lucky this time, get an extra one.
Panskin finds a hook onto one of these key targets. All bets are off for Liquid. Pull him back in. Loda, if they can somehow... A guy, there is no way to kill this guy. They are going to actually hook back in limp, so not going to catch on to Kuro. The Static Storm is down as well, so
might
a lot of
go
damage
down.
Being dealt. They get the vacuum wall back onto 3, but still a lot of damage being dealt out.
Antimate,
and they also have the Guardian Angel.
Ultimate.
Oh, they haven't been able to catch up to him, though, and the Lincoln's popped because the Ember put it on him. Chasing down Jonas is Miracle, who's outside of the base right now and nobody else around. They're still backing out. They do not want to end up dropping here as the jump forward crush, GH. Yeah, he's just going to drop there. So they lose their Slardar and now pull back in Matumbo Man. Purification, but it's too much damage coming in from Loda. He finally pops off the ulti.
And that's the extra
the
illusion. Lucky 50. 5 CKs hitting your base. I think the Rexes are down for them. Just going to switch to mid now.
This is so tough, and Limp is just running at him. Again, a vacuum into 2. Kuroki, he'll get the catch, but they're not able to hook him back in.
Yeah, look at the damage coming out from CK. Just amazing.
Yeah, this has been a really tough game for Liquid as shrines are popped and is trying to hold on right now. There isn't much that they can do. They have found Miracle back by the secret shop, who's trying to finish off the rest of his items and being slowed by the poison touch. It is going to get the stun, the crush, but it might make enough space for Miracle to get out. He gets his evasion. they're hanging on. He's got a butterfly. Maybe this is the
nice
item. We'll turn it all back around.
We got him.
Oh, man.
1 melee rex to go. And CK is full HP, 4,000.
They get
HP.
The dismember, Static Storm down onto 2, Miracle still held in place.
They're so tanky.
Break the Lincolns here, it's just, they're not doing anything. There's no damage being dealt right now, and Miracle pulled back in. He's going to do some damage to himself as well with those illusions.
And
end up finding that hook. Kuroki gone, Miracle gone, everybody dead.
Yeah, pretty
Alliance
much, that's
will
it.
End up winning.
Wow. Really nice game coming up from Alliance. I'm surprised they managed to beat them 33-3. All right. Really nice performance by all of them, actually.
It was a tough showing. I wasn't fully expecting a 1-1, but kind of an interesting result. The two games, would you say that was sort of